In this video, I'm gonna hack Michael's password on his Windows computer, and I'm gonna show you how. It will involve grabbing his password hash and cracking it with tools from Kali Linux.
So we're gonna wait for him to go to the bathroom. He normally leaves his computer unlocked, which is really bad. Don't do that. So we're gonna wait and watch, and then we're gonna rush in there. All right, there he goes. He's going to the bathroom. All right, this is our window. Come on, come on, come on. Let's go. Oh, wait, I forgot my coffee. Okay, okay. Now we can hack. Oh, almost spilled it. Wait, what?
Now, disclaimer, what I'm about to show you is a real hacking technique and should only be used ethically, meaning you have explicit permission and you're following all the rules. And in this situation, I'm Michael's boss, so I make the rules.
So right now I do have full access to Michael's desktop, but only for a moment. If I want to have it forever, I need to find his password. But there is one problem though. Windows doesn't just store his password plain text on the system. It's stored inside a hash.
Like most modern systems and applications, when you set up a password, they don't store that password the way you see it, like this. No, they don't do that. They take it and they put it through a hashing algorithm. And in the case of Microsoft, it's the MD4 hashing algorithm. So they hash it up to where it will look something like this. And that's what they store as your password. It's not your password. It's a hashed version of it. And when you try to log in, they put that back through their little calculation algorithm thing, their hash. And if it spits out the same hash that they have stored, you're in. We want that hash. We need it. And while it won't immediately tell us his password, it will. We'll crack it. And actually later, I'll show you how we can just use the hash itself to do some pretty gnarly things. It's kind of crazy.
Now to get his hash, it's found in his system's registry. It's in two places. Let's get it real quick. I'll go to my search bar and search for regedit. There it is right there. Notice I am getting a UAC prompt. I do have to be administrator. Good news is Michael is an administrator. Here we're looking at the HKey local machine, and we want the SAM and system keys. Now I could export them here, but we don't have time. We have to hurry up. So we're gonna do it via command line. I'm gonna launch my terminal as administrator. And with one command, I can grab them. It'll be reg save, specify the key, HKLM, SAM, and then I'll specify where to save it. I'll just put it right here, sam.save. Got it. Same thing for the system. We'll grab system, save that to system.save, and we got it. Wait, is that him? All right, I gotta be quick. He can be back at any time, but I have to tell you how you can protect yourself from bad passwords with Dashlane. Dashlane is my password manager of choice and the sponsor of this video. Now, I really hope that Michael has been using Dashlane for his Windows password. Actually, I kinda hope he has it. It's gonna make my job so much harder to hack it. Now, I love Dashlane because they make it really easy to create complicated, hard to hack passwords for all your services. And they'll tell you if it's not a good password, and they'll make sure you have a unique password for everything. That's probably the main reason people get hacked. I'm really curious what Michael's password is. We're gonna find out. Now, honestly, I should already know if Michael is using good passwords because I force all of my employees to use Dashlane because I use it for my business. I can look at their password scores, make sure they're healthy, and make sure their passwords aren't compromised on the dark web. So check it out, link below, dashlane.com/networkchuck50, or you can use code networkchuck50 and you'll get 50% off. Don't be like Michael, don't get hacked. Okay, he's coming back soon. Okay, let's get this going. Now, all I gotta do is put this on a flash drive, which I'm just not realizing I don't have. I'll be right back. Let's go. Where's the flash drive? Crap. Got one. Okay, go. No, shh. Okay. All right. Okay, I'll open up my Finder right here, copy these two files, save them to our flash drive, our external hard drive, and we're good to go. All right, I think I hear him coming. He doesn't even know. What a sucker.
Okay, I've got him. I'm gonna go plug him in. My computer's in my server room. And there it is, and there they are. Sam.save, system.save. I'm gonna take those, copy, and I'll paste them right here on my desktop. Bam, there they are. I'll jump to my desktop and my terminal, cd desktop. There's my two files. Now to get the hash out of these guys, we're gonna use a tool called mpacket secrets dump. That's a weird name. It's built into Kali, let's try it out. And if you need to install it, of course, sudo apt, let's just do a search, before mpacket, and you can find it pretty easily. Here's the command, mpacket, secrets dump, we'll do a -sam, which is where Windows actually stores these NTLM hashes. NTLM is their net logon manager, it manages the password stuff. And we'll specify our file sam.save. And then we'll do -system and specify our system.save. And local because we're parsing local files right here. And let's try it out. Do you see all that? There's a lot here. Let me make this more legible for you. We have the hashes, by the way. We got the administrator hash, and there's Michael right there. The hash is actually right here. This is what we need, and we have it. So I'm gonna grab this and save it. Create a file called hashes.txt, paste that in there, Control X, Y, enter to save. We got it. Now at this point, we have the hash, and we need to crack the password. And if you've seen my password cracking video, which if you haven't yet, go check it out. I detail a lot of what password cracking entails. This is what it normally is. You have a password hash, and now we have to guess what the password might be for it. Now, if you recall from our example earlier, we're kind of like Microsoft, the Windows computer. All we have is the hash. And instead of waiting for a user to put the password in and go, yep, that's it, we're gonna try a bunch of passwords. Like a lot, and try and guess what the password is. Thankfully, we have tools that can automate that, and they'll be able to tell us what the right password is. But we gotta do a few things to make it work. First, we'll need a list of passwords that could be Michael's password. And when I say a list, I mean like thousands, probably 20,000 passwords. How do we do that? There's a tool for it, I'll show you here in a second. But what we're doing here, getting a list of passwords and trying them all with a tool, that's called a dictionary attack. And it's what most password crackers, hackers use. So when you hear about a data breach and people, you know, have their emails and their passwords compromised, it's normally an email address and a password hash. And these hackers will do what I'm doing right now. Get a bunch of well-known passwords or randomly generated passwords and just start going at it, automated. Let's try it real quick. Now to generate our list of passwords, we're gonna use a tool called cup, which is really, really fun. Check it out. Let's see if I have it installed. Nope. Do I wanna install it? Sure, yes. Cool, that was easy. So what we'll do here is we'll type in cup-i for interactive mode. And what this will do is ask us questions about our target, name, date, birth date, significant other, hobbies, keywords. It will use that information to generate a random list of passwords. Well, not so random. So let's try it out. First name, Michael. Surname, Wall. Nickname, Michael. We'll do birthday. Partner's name, Amanda. Panda, Asher. Pet's name, Bree. Company name, Network Chuck. Don't want some keywords? Sure. Let's do Beatles. He likes the Beatles. Summer 2023. Monkeys. Bible. Jesus. Okay, I think we're good. Special characters? Sure. Yeah, let's do that. Leap mode? Don't know what that is. Saying no. Okay, do you see that? That was so fast. It just generated 17,000 words and put it inside a file called michael.txt. Let's cat that real quick. Cat michael.txt. Look at all that. Possible passwords that he might have. So now let's see if he has that password. For this, we're gonna use a very popular cracking tool, password cracking tool, called Hashcat. I go deeper into how to use this in my password hacking video. So we'll start our command. We'll do a sudo hashcat. We'll do a -m to specify our hash type. We're doing NTLM, so it'll be 1000. That's again what Windows uses. I know this from reading the man page. Then we'll specify our hashes. We created a hash file called hashes.txt with Michael's hash in it. And then finally our dictionary, our word list, michael.txt. Let's see how this works. Ready, set, go, 17,000 passwords. Let's try it. Okay, there we go. Status cracked. Let's do that same command and we'll do a --show and it should output for us the hash and the password in its database. Okay, there it is. That should be his password. So we have his hash, we have his password. Now what do? We hack him. We get in. We can use tools like evil-winrm, which is as fun as it sounds. We'll do a -i. Specify his IP address. Now I do happen to know this because he's here at my office, right? And I could have figured that out doing ipconfig while I was at his computer. So that's his IP address. Do username, Michael-p. I'll put in that password we found and let's see what happens. Shell right there. Who am I? I'm Michael. I'm in his computer right now. Yep, that's his IP address. That's a Windows machine. Pretty crazy, right? We can do something better. Let me exit out of there. We can RDP with a tool xfree. RDP, do a /v for the computer, /u for the user, password. And that should be all I need. Let's try it out. Seems to be working. What the heck? Got him. How cool is that though? Now, let me show you something crazier. We cracked the password and I happen to know Michael, so I could have generated that list and you know, had a pretty good list of passwords, but we don't need it. Check it out. Our same command before, evo winrm, we could just do a dash H. Let me open up a new terminal and grab that real quick. We'll grab that hash. Oh wait, that's not it. It's a capital H. Did you see that? I logged in with the hash, not even the password. That's kind of crazy, right? It's called pass the hash. And we can do the same thing with RDP. Same command as before, but instead of dash or slash P, we'll do a PTH for pass the hash. Paste the hash there. There's a fly in here. Get out of here, fly. But look, it worked. How amazing is that? Oh, I lost it. Try it again. We're back in. He's gotta be freaking out right now. So, what I just showed you is how you can get a hash from a Windows computer and figure out the password from that hash, or just use the hash itself to get access to a bunch of stuff. It's kind of crazy, it's powerful, it's really fun. But now let's move on to the defensive side of things. Let's talk about mitigation. And this is actually good news for security people, because the method I used here is already documented pretty well in the MITRE meter framework, OS credential dumping with security account manager. Sorry, this fly is driving me nuts. You'll notice that, hey, we're dumping the same keys that they're mentioning. So it's documented. And they're even saying the tools that we may have used. Secrets dump, what? But what's cool is they do offer mitigations. Disabling or restricting NTLM, putting in password policies, user training. And they also give you detection stuff, like you actually detect when people are doing stuff with their registry keys. So that's good news. And also, full disclosure, we had to do a few things to Michael's PC to make this work. Disable certain security features that prevented us from doing things. Now, we did get the hash, no problem. We didn't have to do anything for that. But in order for me to do the winrm command giving me a shell, I had to disable his firewall, the Windows firewall. In order for me to do the RDP, same thing, firewall. I also had to enable remote desktop and add Michael to the allowed users to access remote desktop. And I had to disable a setting in the registry called disable restricted admin, which was a flaw back in Windows 8 that they had to fix. So we did have to do a few things to make it work. So if you try to do this yourself and you're like, I'll put some information down below how you can like do this yourself with your own little lab. It's pretty fun. But just know, default security posture of Windows is pretty good. Now, it doesn't mean that what I've done here cannot be done by a pretty good hacker, or that a user may just have a computer that's wide open. So I hope in this video you saw another window into Windows of how vulnerable we kind of are, but also how secure we are as well. And also, I wanted to address something, because back in my password hacking video, you know, I talked about, oh, we can crack hashes, but the number one question I got was, how do you get those hashes? Well, in this video, I showed you how you could get those hashes, at least a potential way. And by the way, I've only scratched the surface of what you can do here. This is a very basic example, a basic demo. There's a whole big world to this. That's all I got. I'll catch you guys later.